You look so tan.
Oh, thank you.
My God.
Yeah, I'm in the sun right now. That's what this is. My hands are getting darker by the second.
So you're applying that material?
My gosh, you're so smart. Yes, Shlomo.
Oh, my God.
It's Westmore Beauty, you guys. I'm caught.
I love it.
It's coverage perfector.
Wow. Is it for men or just for women?
Well, anybody. But before I shoot, I like to use this so I'm nice and tan.
So nice.
I know. Thank you. It's very good. I'm kind of obsessed with it. And it goes well with my new top. Do you like my new top?
Wow. Is that, you know what?
What?
Is that from Italy?
It is.
Is it made by Gigi?
Shop Gigi Moda.
Oh, my God.
On
I know
Instagram.
The line.
Shop
oh, my
Gigi
God.
Moda. It's a beautiful lace.
Beautiful.
Get yours now.
I like it. I like it.
You can wear it. In white.
In white.
Okay, good. Let's start the show.
All right. I'm optimistic.
Oh, oh, I'm strangely optimistic. Hello, everybody. It's me again. Today I have a very exciting guest, a very, very talented special guest. His mother and father were both deaf mutes. In Israel, this is where he was born. This person is a fantastic artist. I love having people on the show like this that are an incredible example of rags to riches. And you're going to learn why, and you're going to see his beautiful art. I'm really excited to show you. It's brilliant. His name is Shlomo Tuvia.
Hi.
Hello. We have applause on this show, but this is the Imperfect Podcast. Welcome, Shlomo.
Thank you very much for having me.
So lovely to meet you, sir. We're
delightful.
Just meeting everybody.
Really delightful to be here and
you know, he just
share my information.
You just flew in from, he's wearing his sunglasses because he just flew in from Miami. And
exactly. And it was so hot. And you know, when I got
which is why you wanted
the
hot coffee. We
you
gave
know
you the
what?
Hot coffee.
I'm having a little bit good coffee made by a beautiful guy. His name is Salomon.
Yeah, I like the cool artist look, by the way.
And
it is.
I just wanted to say that I'm so happy to be now in LA.
Yes.
And we're doing great, great shows. We have ones coming probably in West Hollywood.
West Hollywood?
Yes.
Wait, you just had 5 in Europe, first of all.
Correct.
2 in Rome.
Correct.
1 in Parma.
Yes.
1 in, Venice.
And then Verona. Wow.
Oh my gosh.
You had the V.
And you also just had one that you didn't invite me to because you forgot.
I know. LA Art Show, I'm having every year.
I didn't get to go.
You know, this year, because I was changing the gallerist asked me to do something special. He said, Shlomo, you're doing a lot of figurative and you do a lot of realism.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you do
abstract
this year? Abstract. So he gave me 3 months before the show, and I came up with some pieces. He came in, he says, Shlomo, I love it. We will sell it, I promise.
Oh my gosh.
So I went to the show. I didn't invite a lot of friends this time because normally I bring like 10 pieces.
Wow.
So I came in, and all the pieces are gone, and we have orders.
God. Oh my God. Do you guys want to see why? Can we please show? This is my favorite piece, by the way.
Thank
right.
You.
At least right now. There's so many.
Thank
Look
you.
At that. I'm going to get into, you have so many amazing ones. Can we stop right there on just that one and not go forward? He has more art I want to show. The significance of the hands, you guys, because his parents were deaf mute and speaking with the hands is so significant.
Correct.
And that affected your art, especially in the beginning, right? Or always?
I decided about 5 years ago, one gallerist came to me and he says, you know, you have a unique story. Uh-huh. Why don't you paint just anything to do with hands and try to have your thought into the painting, what you went through in your life.
Oh, wow.
You know, the silence and all that stuff.
Wow.
And, you know, what you see here in the blue, you see it's a male hand and a female hand. And they're actually looking for freedom and the birds coming out of them.
Ugh.
And light blue and dark blue is just a happy sign for everybody. And
sorry, he's getting a call right now. It's another order. He's got another order.
Yes.
Tell them to wait. God, you're on the Josie Davis and Perfect podcast. No. You got to stop.
I will call you back, Jane.
Take off your glasses now that you're here and settled from Miami.
Oh, my God.
Put your phone down, your glasses.
Oh, my God.
You got your coffee.
You're right. He's so busy, you guys.
Your arms must be tired.
You're right. But I wanted to tell you, I'm so excited to be here, and anything you wanted to know about the shows.
Yes, I'm very excited. You guys, I want to tell you, I mentioned he's rags to riches, so I'm going to want to find out how you, oh my gosh, wait a minute. Let's start out with when you were born in Israel with your parents.
Who came from Romania.
Please.
And they escaped the Holocaust.
Yeah.
And they didn't know each other in Europe, but they came from the same village, but they didn't know each other.
How did they escape the Holocaust?
Oh my God! They were just lucky. They were on the sewer, and for 2 years they lived in the sewer.
In the sewer?
That's my mom's family.
Okay.
And my father's family, a lot of unknown, and it's hard for me to understand what really happened.
Wow.
And
wow.
And when they immigrated to Israel, they were like a matchmakers, and somehow they were from the same village. Called Yashi in Romania. And they got married. They didn't know anything in Israel. They didn't know reading, writing. They couldn't even add 1 + 1 = 2.
Oh, my God.
So when I was born, like the age of 4, back then, you know, not like we get an envelope with a bill and then we send in the mail. I had to go to the city hall to pay the bill. You know,
wait a minute. You were born on the beach, you told me, on the sand.
On the sand. And then they took me to the hospital
from
there. So it was not much on the sand, you know. But
and
yes.
Then you lived in, you were living in Israel, right?
In a one bedroom. Four of us, me and my brother and my parents.
Yeah.
And we were sharing the beds. Oh. I mean, it was during the day we fold the sofas. So we'll have where to, you know. But most of the time, we were outside, kids playing in the sand, and we didn't have asphalt. So
how did they make a living?
No asphalt. My mom worked in Weizmann Institute, which is, there's a lot of inventions over there, and it's a very special place. She worked in the library, washing the dishes, whatever it is, and then she would walk back to the house about 4 miles with bags of food and old-fashioned way. And I grew up really on dirt road, donkeys. I used to work when I was 5, 6 years old delivering ice blocks. I don't know if you know anything about ice blocks.
They used to have picks, ice picks.
Right.
I know that because of Laurel and
right.
Hardy.
Right, and that's Hardy. Before the refrigerator and the freezer in Israel. Few people who could afford probably had already a refrigerator, but my neighborhood, nobody had a refrigerator.
Wait, what did your dad do?
My dad worked in the construction, but then he fell and he was at home for about 5 years. And then he went to work in some bottling company or whatever.
Wow,
and, you know, they were hardworking people, not knowing what's going on around them.
Wow. And you were the older brother.
I am the older brother, and my young brother was actually under me, and even till today we have a great relationship. And
is it still kind of almost a dad son thing?
That's what it is.
Uh-huh.
A lot of respect, and I remember when he wanted to smoke cigarette, he wouldn't smoke next to me, and he was 17 years old, he would not smoke next to me.
Wow.
Yeah, just respect.
Wow. So wait, so how did you end up sort of helping your becoming like the dad? How did your mom and dad?
While they were at work, you were taking care of him? Just naturally. It's just.
My mom just did the same with her sister.
Amazing.
Sister, because my uncle had polio. So similar thing.
Oh my God.
They took the family, took the son to the hospital and they were with him with the iron lung and all that. He couldn't breathe. And so my mom's older sister became like the mom. Now I know why she's obsessed with hanging out with her sister. And I'm always like, where are you? You know, but it makes sense.
Right, right.
Kind of.
Right.
So after you're with your brother, so how did, sorry, I have so many questions. What did you do for work when you started to earn money? And how old were
you?
Oh,
I did a lot of stuff.
How old were you?
I was maybe 6 or 7 years old and I would hire a year younger.
Wait. You were 6 or 7 years old, and you what?
And I did business. And I tell you what the business is. You know what the baby carriage, like you put the baby?
Yeah.
So I used to go to richer neighborhood and see stuff they don't really need. Brought them home. I put stuff in it. And we made like hummus with pita and popcorn, put it in bags. And I had kids sitting in the city and selling. And I would walk and collect and collect.
You
and
guys.
Who is cheating, who's not cheating too.
What is going...
Like, in other words, if you had 30 bags and you said, I don't have money.
6 or 7 years old?
Yes.
What are your kids doing at 6 or 7 years? What were you doing at 6 or 7 years old? Do you understand? Can we show more of his art for a second? Because I want people to understand.
Please.
I can't even talk. Do you see this art?
This is
a special person and born out of what you came from to where you are now. Can we show more? Is just, it's remarkable. It's just,
I love tulips.
It's brilliant work. I told you, I have special people on this show. Can we show more? Can we show another one? There's so many. We're not going to keep look at this.
This man have a pass and nobody knows. Right now he works for the Lord and he's working for wealthy people and he have, if you see the ring.
The tattoo also.
Exactly. The tattoo shows that he was somebody in his younger age.
Yes.
And he's.
Rebellious.
Right. And
I see it.
You can see the ring. Do you see the evil eye that he have?
Uh-huh.
So that shows me that he could be coming from the Middle East before he moved to England and he became more decent and maybe he learned a better culture. And
my God,
so, yeah.
There's a lot in that picture.
Thank you. Yeah.
Wow. A lot to look at. He's got the cane and
I love it.
The ring. Who knows what that means?
I love it. So I wanted to tell you,
just
watching it and just being here with you and appreciate it. And I wanted to do more art.
Yeah.
And more giving. And by the way, I'm involved, with the children's hospital and all that stuff that I like to give. It's not all about the money.
Yes. Yeah. It's we didn't even get into the money. We got into being 6 or 7 years old.
So if we're going back to six, 7 years old.
And we'll come back to
When I was 9, 10, I was in charge of the newspaper of the town newspaper, which was for free.
How
obviously.
Did you do that?
Talking and
connections. Solomon, you should be a producer in Hollywood. Oh,
no.
We'll talk about that later.
So I used to have a group of kids who would go and they'd say, okay, you will do the north of the city, you'll do the south of the city.
Oh my God.
And we used to, one day I said, you know what? I want to make money. I don't want the kids to come. I just want to pocket all the money.
Uh-huh.
So I took another kid with me and we threw all the newspaper in one big bin, the end of the city. Wind came in and all the newspaper came out from that bin and flew all over the city. One lady called the city and said, there's newspaper all over your paper from the city. So the guy who was in charge of it, he was like a mafioso. And he knew it's me. He came to the neighborhood and he says, where is Shlomo? And I knew he's coming. I was hiding.
Oh no.
And that was the end of the newspaper.
Oh my God.
So, I learned, from young. He wanted to beat me up.
What happened? Did he?
And no, I always hide and hide. And
I used
somehow.
To hide too as a kid. Wow. We have a lot in common. Okay.
So we had fun. And that taught me that from that moment, just go straight and not taking the shortcuts and all that. And you learn because my parents couldn't tell me.
Of course.
And I had my aunt. They were talking to me a lot about life and this and that, but they weren't my parents. So I did whatever.
Survival mode.
One day, I was 10 years old. I had a bicycle. I took my father's bicycle and I drove all the way to my aunt's house. I won a TV. Mm-hmm. Few families starting to have a black and white TV. If you remember, Our Side, Lassie Comes Home. That was the era.
I've heard it. Yes, I've heard of
it. You heard it.
I didn't watch it. Thank
no, but it's my era.
Lassie,
come home. Aww. So I came and she opened the door and I was crying. I said, Auntie Molly, I don't have a TV and we're so poor. And you're sitting here listening to classical, because she was European. Classical music, beautiful area rug. I never sang in my life. And you just live on the asphalt and everything is beautiful. I want to have a TV. Mm-hmm. She said, Ms. Shlomo, you don't understand. You have to grow up. And I told her, you will see. Mm-hmm. Within a week, I'm going to have a TV. I went to all the neighbors and everybody and I borrowed money. I went down to the center of the, and I walk into a TV store and I said, I want to buy a TV. The guy says, kid, go and bring your parent. I said, no, I'm buying a TV. And I,
oh my God.
I took the bag with a lot of cash. Wow. And I said, here's the cash. So the TV was delivered. And
oh my God.
So prior to that, why did I say that I wanted to have a TV? On the second floor of my neighborhood was an older lady. And was a cypress trees in front of her window. So we were climbing. If she had it open, so we can see the TV.
Oh my gosh.
So one time she trusted me and she said, Shlomo, I'm going to sleep. She was old.
Yeah.
And would you make sure to close the window, close the shutters and go down? And I used to do that. So it was a habit. Every day in the evening, mm-hmm. I would sit just like a monkey on a branch watching TV. That's prior me going to Auntie Molly to ask for the TV.
Wow.
So yeah, so all this, you know, the way I conduct my life,
yeah.
I think it made it more colorful. And I think
when you work hard, yeah,
you know, it pays.
The survival pays. Thing, just the drive, that's yes. where the drive comes.
Yes.
And I get it.
You know what
it,
I
get
do?
It, get it.
I try to teach a lot of people.
Yeah, you can't teach the drive.
You cannot.
You can't. Ambition, you can't. It has to come from that inner thirst.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. So, what can I say?
I want to show another piece.
Yeah.
I want to show more. I want them to see more. They've got to see it. And I have to tell you, look at those hands, by the way.
Man is working on the field, dirty hands.
You get hands really great, by the way. I don't see that too often. I get the feeling of the hands.
Yeah.
Can we go to another one too? Sure. Besides the eye. Your hands are excellent.
Yes.
My God. Wow. Do you want to say anything about that one?
That one. Ooh.
Wow.
There's a lot to say.
First
of all, I always feel for workers and people who work hard in the field. And, you know, I don't want to paint any elegant, beautiful, you know what I mean? To me, this is beautiful.
Wow, look at
this. Because this is a real life. Mm-hmm. And obviously, if you look close at the eyes, mm-hmm. you see a lot of suffering.
I do.
And
your art is so emotional. Every time I start to cry.
And it's always going back to my history.
Yes.
And my father used to paint, or draw actually, mm-hmm. German soldiers, the Nazis. The guns, the boots, and blood.
Yeah.
And even though it's only with pencils, but I was watching it and I did not like it. And I never wanted to know about these Nazis and all this. And I'm happy the way it is now. So,
you know, you and I haven't really talked about sort of all this stuff and the fact that my dad was part Jewish. Because his mother was Jewish.
Yes.
And it's a very strange thing because I'm technically, I guess, not Jewish, but then...
It goes by the mom, right?
Yeah, right? So it's weird. It's weird. But the whole... sorry, the mom and the where was I with the Jewish...
with the hand?
No, the artist and the... Because my dad was an artist as well and the suffering in the eyes. So that... But then the Jewish thing is in the mom. Yeah, that's just the whole thing about the Jewish. There's something else I was going to say. Sorry, I forgot what it was.
Okay.
I had too many thoughts going in the art and the suffering and then the whole Jewish thing that and my dad used to say all these Jewish words. I didn't know Yiddish.
Oh, Yiddish,
He would say all these different things I didn't understand.
The older generation, they would say.
I wonder if you guys would have.
I probably would know. I actually learned Yiddish here in Santa Monica.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. And this is when I started doing painting, you know, before I got to the stars, I did like a little bit in Fairfax. So I would go to old lady and she said, you know what? Give me a better price. I'll give you my sister. I go to the sister and she said, young boy, you're so handsome. But give me a good price. I'll give you my neighbor. So I realized I have to escape from that area.
Wow.
I don't
want
to pay because they're all cheap skin. I need to go up there. And that's when I started. I said, you know what? I'm going to look for the studios. I'm going to look for the business managers. And introduce myself and get into the Hollywood in the painting.
That's what I wanted to get into was the painting earlier too. Sorry, there's too many
I have so many names that I
did. Can you talk about who helped you first with the painting? The man that helped you with the first job, I think?
Okay, I was maybe 2 days in United States and I was staying with my uncle and my aunt. They were very old, Holocaust survivors. Mm-hmm. And they live in a little apartment. And my uncle says, come, I'm going to take you to see the mall of Santa Monica. They lived in Santa Monica. So he parked, do you know where the alley behind 3rd Street?
Yeah.
In Santa Monica?
Mm-hmm.
So there is the parking lot.
Mm-hmm.
So he's on the second floor and I see a man on the ladder. It was a tall guy. And he was doing sign, painting sign. And he was black. I said to him, I would love to talk to him. He said, Shlomo, he's not going to talk to you. You just came. You barely know English. I said, can I? So we went down, and I said, hey, man, can I help you? He looked down, and he says, do you know what I do? Do you know what? I said, sure. He came down, gave me the brush, gave me the scissors, and I went up, and I showed him. He says, beautiful. Tonight, I'm doing a restaurant on 3rd Street. Be there at 6 o'clock. My uncle said, what? How did you connect? I said, God is with us.
Yes.
My uncle gave me some dirty clothes, and I went 6 o'clock, and I see all the guys. He says, you know what? I have to go. You'll manage those guys.
How old were you?
20. Okay. You will manage the guys. You know, I spoke European English,
mm-hmm.
and it was a restaurant, and the guys were painting. Oh, and he told me, make sure they don't steal from the freezer meat.
Mm.
Of course, in the morning, the owner came and he saw less meat in the freezer. He came to me and he came in the morning and he says, don't come back to work. I said, listen. Now I understand. I didn't know about the back door.
Uh-huh.
They were stealing it from the back door. I'll make sure.
Okay.
Give me the key. And we became best friends.
Oh, my.
And they call us the black and the white guy.
Wow.
We used to have a long station wagon and hanging sign in Hollywood all over.
That's what the sign said?
All over.
Oh my God.
Sunset, Hollywood Boulevard, everywhere in LA. Until one day I said, you know what? I want to move on. And I moved on. Fast forward, 40 years later, I'm walking on Venice. And I see a man walking like him, but old, very old. And I wasn't my two boys. And his name was Al. And I said, you know what? I'm going to say Al. If it's him, it's him.
Wow.
He turned around. He looked at me and he started crying. Chomo. He started crying. And I started crying. And we were hugging and we didn't want to let go.
Oh, my God.
And people surrounding us right on the walkway. Everybody came. So what's going on? These two people are hugging each other. And then it was very touchy and it was very... And my boy's like, what's going on? Who is this man?
Oh my God.
I told them and I said, tell him thank you because he was so welcoming when I came to the United States. He was so nice to me. And we lost. We lost the connection. I wish I knew him later on when I start doing construction and painting and I would integrate him... with us.
How old was he then?
He was older. I was like 20.
You think he's gone?
Don't know. I saw him like 2 years ago.
2 years ago?
2 years ago. He probably was 80 something.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
You didn't get his phone number?
No. We were just, it was too exciting. I wish I did, actually.
Oh, my God. Yeah. How weird. Oh, yeah. My God. Oh, boy, is this, like, emotional or what?
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm like, can we show more of his art? Let's just get a little more. And go to the next one after we saw this is ridiculous. Isn't this recent? Oh
yes.
My God. This one is for me a special.
what you see here is a friend of mine. He's Russian. He took a photo of this, of a man somewhere in the world that have, do you see the machete? And the shirt is overgrown and the pants is overgrown, showing hardship. And look at his hand. If you could see it close. To me, it's somewhere in a Spanish country. A man just taking a break from the field that's the photo. And I never put it for sale or anything, like just kept it because it means a lot to me. You know, it means some suffering of people and means a lot. So I'm not selling
it. No, I wouldn't. This is a special. Yeah,
this one I kept.
You got into very quickly, because I said you're rags to riches and it wasn't just from art, it was also from real estate.
I used to have a painting company.
Not that we have to get into it, but that's just your other.
And then I start, buying and fixing and.
Yeah.
And I always attracted to design homes and all that. And I do it till today.
Yeah.
I'm just enjoying it.
And now, when's your next show?
The next one will be in West Hollywood.
Yeah, when is it? Am I invited to that one?
Yes. No. This time, I'm going to make sure.
It's okay. We don't know each other that well.
No, we do know. We know each other for many years.
No, it hasn't been many years.
How many years? At least two.
No,
close to two.
No, really?
Yeah, time flies.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right.
So,
okay, when is it? When is the next one?
I don't have the date.
Well, wait, is this the abstract art?
That will be an abstract. He asked me to make 12 pieces.
Yeah.
Because there was demand for what I did, he asked me to just make 12 pieces and it will be a solo show somewhere around, I forgot the name of the place.
Oh my gosh, we have to announce it. You guys, can we also announce?
It's La Cienega and.
Can we show his Instagram so that you guys can write this down and watch his. Maybe go to his next show.
Yeah, I would love to.
Oh, it's killer. Now, these are larger pieces, right?
Yeah, they would be about 5x6, 4x5.
Wow.
It's going to be good size, and it could go to every home. Any.
I told you that my dad was an artist. And
I know. And you say you're going to show me the painting.
I'm going to show you some. His stuff is same kind of, the eyes are all really, lonely and stuff. He's the tallest one that he ever made. I remember it on the wall. He sold to James Franco, and it was a very, I always picture it as there was not a halo, but like someone's soul or something above the head, you know?
Yeah.
It was pretty cool. That was his tallest one I've ever seen, but he does have there's some really large ones.
I would love to see it.
Yeah. Too. I'll share them with you, and they're pretty wild. And
sure.
I'm very touched, obviously, by your art.
See it.
Yeah.
Emotional. Yes.
Yeah. Usually the show is rip-roaringly hilarious,
but you know what?
You and I laugh a lot, but
yes.
This is we're touching on
getting into a subject. Yes.
Serious stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the history, but this is why, I talk every episode about how my show is about being of service and it's to you for your art so people are aware of your art. So it can be appreciated, but it's also so people can learn, how did he do this? How did he, against adversity, growing up like that, develop this incredible business sense coming from this thirst of, survival
survival.
I know.
Pure survival.
And I get it, yeah. Except I feel I'm behind you sometime here. But that's okay, I have more life. I'm not dead yet.
It is. But I'm involved also in organization.
Oh, I wanted you to mention that. With what children's hospital? What are you doing?
No, there is a guy that takes my stuff. And actually I went with, what do you call these people with the red head in downtown?
An auctioneer? No, they're not auctioning it off. No. What do you, a red hat?
Yeah.
Salvation Army?
Not Salvation Army.
Oh.
Red Cross?
They work with the Red Cross.
Okay.
Big organization.
Oh.
And they're helping a lot. I went to that hospital and I saw kids, without legs.
Shriners.
Thank you.
Shriners, there we go.
You could see I have actually one interview with them.
And so they take your art?
Yeah, and also the auction.
And the money goes there?
Because they have a lot of events.
Wow.
So it's wonderful. And I actually went and I saw in front of my eyes, I met the head of the hospital.
Yes, you have to.
And they show me, oh my God, and I saw kids.
Oh my God.
Everybody should come and at least see and try to help.
So wait, when is your do you know when your show is yet?
No, not the one in West L.A.
Okay, West Hollywood.
Sorry, yeah.
So make sure and check, you know, his Instagram, you guys, Shlomo Art.
Shlomo Tuvia Art.
I'm sorry, Shlomo Tuvia Art.
One
and
word,
that's,
yeah.
Yeah, not S-C-H. And can we show more art, please?
Yeah, I think we have actually two of the modern pieces. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, let's put these up here.
Oh, this, my God.
This is basically...
Oh, my God.
It's a canvas.
Oh, my God. Shlomo.
I made it look like a wood.
Yeah.
That you found traveling in the ocean for about 20 or 30 years.
Shlomo.
Somebody found it, but it's all painting.
Holy.
It's all, it's a painting technique with some plaster.
God, I'm dying over.
The painting looked like it's peeling and...
Oh my, I'm looking so far into the woods right now.
Exactly.
Holy.
And also, it's a forest.
It is.
It's
That's what I'm saying. It goes so deep. Oh, my God. It's incredible.
And I hope this particular piece
You know, there's just
go.
So much art that drives me nuts where I look at it and it looks like a child could have done it.
Right.
Why would you buy that when you can buy this? This is for a deep person, though. I think some of this art these days is for someone who's, a shallow person. That's incredible.
But...
Wow, and the wood that you did it on, that's insane.
But
the depth of...
It's not wood.
But sorry, the wood...
The wood-like, yeah.
Thank you, the wood pieces.
Correct.
But the depth of this and the color, that's sick. And if the longer you look, the deeper it goes, even on the left and the right.
Well, I think this is a great piece.
That's insane. How much is that going to... What will be the price of that?
Not that much. I'm not sure. Maybe 7,000, 8,000.
Not that much, says the kid that lived on the sand.
No, no. Oh, my God. No, what I'm saying is we are thinking to go to the 15,
I
to
know,
the 20,
I
to
know,
the 25.
I know. I'm just making a joke. Not that much.
And then somebody maybe say, no, let's get rid of Shlomo, and that would be 700,000. I don't know. But...
Oh, my God. Yeah. Okay, what's
but
another
I like
one?
This. Yeah,
oh, it's insane. Yeah. It's insane.
So this is the new work. This
we have one more here. Take a look at this.
Yes.
God, I think my dad would flip. It's different than what he
does. This one is...
Look at those.
It's just emotion with... I did a series of those. This is like corals in the ocean.
Oh,
but it gives you... When you look at it, it's just a happy piece, and it's pure abstract.
Happy.
There is no...
It's beautiful.
Yeah,
the
and there's
colors.
A lot going on over there with... you have to see it a lot. It's just...
For those that are just listening, because don't forget, this show is not just for people that are watching, but the colors are so magnificent. And then the very... specific all through the middle and the detail that you have is it looks like it took a long time once you're really looking at it, but I don't know. How long did it
take? No, it takes time. It takes time.
Wow.
It takes time.
And who knows what it is exactly?
Sometimes I do two or three pieces together.
Oh,
so
okay.
You get tired of one
and
then you go to the next one.
So you're working on them simultaneously.
Simultaneously.
Mm-hmm. Gorgeous.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is that all we have, by the way?
Yeah, that's all we have.
Yes.
Oof. You guys, if you want to see more, go to his IG.
Yeah.
Shlomo Tuvia Art. Stunning. I can't wait to go to your show. Wow. Yeah. I'll have to put
and
that on.
It's actually fun in the show. You know, we have drinks. We have a bar.
Thank God.
And no.
Thank God you'll have the drinks.
No, no. But I'm saying there's some hosts. Nice people. And
Where's your sense of humor
and
today?
And then sense of humor. People come with the weird wigs.
Really?
And the color. Oh, yeah. You should come.
I'm not wearing
you
a
would
weird
love.
Wig, though.
No, but I'm saying you can color a little bit.
Here, let's do. We'll be doing this.
Oh, my God. This is
I'll
awesome.
I'll be making. We've got this. Westmore beauty product here. I'm going to be using this to try and Shlomo's face I'll be making him nice and tan with this beautiful product.
Maybe I should do some painting there too.
And the question is, should I wear another Gigi Moda top?
I love Gigi.
I know you do, because you were going to wear a white one for your show, maybe.
Yes. Yes. You know what? It's not bad if you put a t-shirt under. And it doesn't look so, you know.
The lace over the t-shirt. Yeah, you guys.
He's, why not?
This, you know, we're in West Hollywood, actually. Yeah, oh, my God.
I've anything got
the body makeup and the Gigi Moda top. It's perfect.
I love Gigi.
Beautiful. In Italy. Oh, my God.
Wow.
Is there anything else you want to share today?
Oh,
it's been so
much.
Beautiful.
So much.
Oh, my God.
So much. We'll have to do another one.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
I know.
But, I
people say, love coming back here and seeing Solomon and his coffee.
Yeah.
Solomon and his coffee.
And the tears that we have, that we share, and the laughter that we have.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
We love it. We love it. Anything else you want to add before you come back?
Yes. I am I'm working on those 12 pieces, and I'm putting not all of them because I want people to be excited to come and see it live.
Yes.
You put everything on Instagram or Facebook. Yeah, nice. Okay, I saw it already. No.
Then there's nothing off market, so to speak. Like
there
in real estate, they hold back some units in the building, like the Four Seasons, for example.
Exactly.
They
hold a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
Not to mention the live experience is just so much more. I mean, you can't see the detail from a phone screen.
Cannot.
Yeah, it doesn't do
that's,
it justice.
That's beautiful.
He's right. Thank you, Solomon.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry. It's just for,
it'll be on my Instagram. I'll make that an event, you guys, so we can see it. That'll be really
thank
fun.
Thank you. It would be so nice.
All right.
I just wanted to say thank you for inviting me. And, and I'm so happy to be here. Maybe the next episode we'll do just about real estate, how and what. And there's a lot of
detail. If you feel like it, if you want
to. We can do another one.
We'll talk about that later on.
Yes, I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
I do like to end with a beautiful quote because I want people to feel inspired by this show, not only because my guests are always amazing, but by a little quote here.
Sure.
So I'm going to pick one. Your parents probably knew this one.
Probably.
The idea, I mean. Okay.
Sure.
This is a quote by someone named Roy T. Bennett. The greatest problem with communication is we don't listen to understand. We listen to reply.
Oh. Wow.
Wow, wow, wow.
Wow, wow.
On that note, I would like to exit. Thank you.
Thank you.
With
appreciate
peace and love.
Peace and love. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm optimistic. Oh, oh.